Good afternoon, people. We got another video, and today we are going to be looking at the size comparison difference between a standard Sangamo S250 clock and the more earlier spring reserve version. Okay. These ones, they are widely available. You can buy these at most electrical stockists. And this one here, I do believe, is a discontinued model, which is no longer available. So, we're going to have a look at the size comparison between the two, just so that you can see the difference between an average everyday Sangamo S250 and the spring reserve version. And so there we go. Right, let's pick the camera up and let's have a look. Right, there's the two time switches which we've already seen, and to each side we've got the covers. Okay, now we'll start with the covers to start with, just so that you can see that these time switches are of the same diameter. Now, if I was to get this one like this, and get this one like this, if I put them together, you can see that they are the same diameter all the way around. Okay? They meet together quite well. You see? They are the same diameter. You see, that way, and that way, they are the same diameter. Okay? So there we go. But, here's the difference. Okay? If I take this cover and place it flat on the work surface, let me pick the camera up. If I place it flat on the surface, like so, this one is for that time switch. And then you've got this one. Okay, now if I put it next to this one, the size difference will become apparent. And there we go. That is the size difference between the two. So why is this one much taller than this one? Let's screw the covers back onto the time switches and stand the time switches up on end so that you can see the size difference. There's that one. And then there's this one. There we go. Let me pick the camera up. And there we go. That is the size difference between the average S250 clock and the one with the spring reserve inside it. Okay. But it still hasn't answered the question, why is this one taller? Let me take the covers off again. Put the covers to one side, and now we will examine the time switches in detail. Let me pick the camera up. Okay, here is your average everyday Sangamo S250 clock. As you can see, that internal workings, if I pulled the internal workings out of the base, there's the workings. Okay, there's the workings and there's the base. Now, see this here? That fits flush with the top of that base. If I put it back in, There we go. If I press that down, that's if it's going to go. There we go. That has now gone flush with that base. But with this one, you've still got it flush, but look up a bit. You've now got this one here. So you've got two. Okay, now the reason why this one's got two, and this one's only got this one, in the dial, there's the clock face there. But with this one, you've got this one, then the clock face. Okay, that is the difference. And in there, that there, that is why. Okay, that there, that big silver cog, that is the spring in there, the coiled spring for the spring reserve. Okay, that is why this one is much taller than this one. So there we go. That is the size difference, people. And if I put them side to side again, as you can see, the bases are the same height. Okay. The bases are the same diameter. But it's the time switch that is in the bases. This one is much taller than this one. Much taller. And that is why that cover is smaller than that one. So there it is. Now, I've done videos on these time switches. I've done a video on this one and a video on this one, individual videos. So if you wish to know any technical details on this or this, then for this one, search for Sangamo S250 round pattern time switch. And for this one, search for Sangamo S355.2.11 E. Okay, so I've done individual videos for them detailing all the technicals. Let's put the covers back on to finish. And there we go. Cheers.